Hi there, this is Vivi Cameron for Tonic Studios, and today I'm going to be featuring the new STAMP Club. So Tonic is releasing these new three products, a massive floral stamp set with five large florals and a coordinating six pieces die set that will cut the florals in that stamp set. This beautiful floral stamp also includes little sentiments to stamp your papercraft projects. In addition to this, Tonic is also releasing this massive sentiments and banner stamp set that includes 37 individual stamps. And I'm totally loving the sentiments to stamp in the back of your cards or your boxes or your envelopes. So today I want to share with you super duper easy ideas to make cards and also to stamp your boxes or 3D projects. So I'm going to start by using this cardstock by Tonic Studios. It's 300 grams, so it's very thick. And I found this amazing to do ink blending. It's not as great to do coloring, but I found this paper ideal to do ink blending with distress inks, Nubo hybrid inks, or any other dye ink you might have. Now, I'm going to use a low tack tape to keep the paper in place because I'm going to be tracing some lines using those Nubo alcohol markers and a ruler. And I'm also going to use the grid on the glass mat to guide myself and to get this straight. So pay attention because I'm using the chisel nib of the markers to do this. And as simple as that, I'm just going to trace some lines. Some of that ink is going to stay on the ruler, so you will see me cleaning the ruler to avoid cross ink contamination, because if not, I will drag that ink to the next step. So this is super duper easy. There is no mystery, and perhaps you need to use some cleaning solution to clean the ruler. You can use the stamping cleaner. You can also use rubbing alcohol or something to remove that ink from the ruler. Nail polish remover should also work. You can use any colors you might like. I'm using here the colors of the rainbow. You can go as dark as you want, as subtle as you want, and you can trace these lines in a diagonal across the panel or in horizontal. The sky is the limit for you to get crafty creating backgrounds like this, and then making some very simple compositions over this. You can add die cuts, you can stamp over this, but today we're going to use the stamps of this month. So once you have your panels done, the first thing I will advise is to die cut them with some kind of frame dies that allows you to die cut or emboss a nice pattern around those panels. I'm going to be listing in the video description some of those dies that I use very often. Next, I'm going to grab the stamp set, and I'm really loving this large floral cluster. So I'm going to use this one to stamp on the panels using black Nubo hybrid ink. And I like to use the stamping platform because it allows me to stamp over and over on the same spot, achieving a very crisp and nice image. This large floral cluster is very versatile. You can stamp it in the center of your project, towards a side, and well, the sky's the limit. You can also use this to stamp your boxes or to create decorative paper for your boxes. So I just die cut this one here because I'm going to make a box with this piece here, and I'm going to put together three simple projects for you. And I'm going to heat emboss three different sentiments for those projects. I want to share with you a tip to get perfect heat emboss sentiments. And this is to get an anti-static posh. It's this one here, and all you have to do is to rub it on the paper, and that is going to avoid the embossing powder to stick on areas where you haven't applied ink. So this will allow you to get really nice, crisp, heat embossed images. I could not live without that. I bought that little tool 7 years ago, and it's a lifetime investment. It's very cheap, it's very affordable, and it will last forever. And it makes such a difference when you are heat embossing. There are another anti-static tools on the market. I'm going to list those in the video description for you, but that one is really, really cool. Okay, so when I have the sentiments stamped using clear ink, all I have to do is to sprinkle some of this white extra fine Nuvo embossing powder. It comes in this square bottle and it's called Glacier White. It's one of my favorites. Then you have to heat set this, and all you have to do is to trim banners for your projects. I like to use the Maxi Guillotine to cut the banners, but I also like to shape the banners, has little tags, and I like to add twine to the little banners as well. So once I have all the banners, all I do is to adhere them with foam pads, or I also like to add a backing layer using some mirror cardstock, silver or gold. That makes the sentiments to stand out and to look really nice. This is a very sweet and elegant touch for clean and simple projects. So here I have all the panels, and I'm going to put together a box really quick just to give you extra ideas. So I'm going to use a piece of paper that measures 6 inches and a half by 6 inches and a half, and I'm going to score at 1 inch. Once I have this done, I'm going to trim the flaps of the box like so. And I'm going to do this all around the edges of that piece of paper. Then I'm going to adhere the flaps in place, shaping that lid of the box. And once I have that done, I'm going to adhere the topper over. To make the body of the box, we are going to need a piece of paper that measures 6 inches 3/8 by 6 inches 3/8. So this piece is just a hair smaller than the piece I used to make the lid. I'm going to do the same process to put this together. And because the piece used to make that base was slightly shorter, like a hair shorter than the piece of paper I used to make the lid, this is going to guarantee a perfect fit. So there you go. This is a way to make your own DIY boxes. But remember that you can also stamp over the panels of your die-cut boxes. Okay, I already adhered those panels on card bases. And this measures about 4 inches and a half by 5 inches and a half. You can make this in any size. For one of the cards, I added the front panel using foam pads, so it has a little bit of dimension. And for the other one, I just adhered the panel using Nuvo Deluxe adhesive. I'm embellishing this a little bit using a Nuvo marker. This is a glitter marker, so that it adds that shine in the center of the flowers. And I'm also going to use sequins to embellish and to finish these projects. So there you go. This is how you do super duper easy paper craft from scratch and with minimal supplies. Of course, you can use any of the products from the Tonic Studios Stamp Club this month to make different cards. For this one here, I use Nuvo glitter markers and Nuvo hybrid inks to do an ink blending background. And in my blog today, I'm sharing step by step with pictures to show you how to add colors to this image here in this card. And well, that's all for today. I hope you enjoyed this video. Do not forget to subscribe to my channel. The links to shop and with supplies is in the video description. Thank you very much for watching, and happy crafting. Bye.